Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I'm going to show you 7 little known tips inside of Lightroom that's going to help you a ton. Alright, so let's start with number 1. You know what, when you're working inside the develop module and you're here and you're kind of scrolling, especially when you get to a laptop and you run out of space, some things are open, some aren't, and you're before you know it, you're scrolling everywhere, and you don't want to do this much scrolling. Well, what you can do is right click on the little arrow, choose solo mode. Then once you choose solo mode, only one panel will be open at a time. So that means when we go down here and we click, say, detail, all the other panels will collapse, or we can go to tone curve, and notice we don't have to scroll for miles anymore. We can get exactly what we want right there. Okay, number 2, let's go into the basic here, and notice the sliders. We've got yay amount of throw there, so we can play around with them, but I want to make those sliders longer to give me more sensitivity. So just click on the edge, and you can drag that panel out as far as it'll go, and notice now how much longer these sliders are now, and that gives us more precise control. So I always do that, and by the way, when we go into the different panels, notice that the way we drag them will be remembered inside each panel. So once you've pulled that out in the develop module, it's always going to be like that. Tip number 3. One of the things I love to do a lot is to use the radial filter in order to get a vignette. So say I grab this picture here and I want to put a radial around it. I can go here into the develop module and I grab the tool here. And as you see, you know, you're probably used to this. You can drag it around. And, you know, maybe we can drop the exposure down with creating a vignette. Now, what if you want to make it fit exactly into that image? You know, we can kind of drag it around like that, but that takes too long. If you hold down the control key, that would be command on Mac, double click on the pin, and boom, notice it will now perfectly fit the bounds of that image. What if we want to hide some of these modules? Notice all these modules up here. All we're going to do is right click, and we can actually, if we're not using the web module, we can hide it. If we're not going to be using the book module or the map module, notice we can right click and just have the modules that we want. That actually goes beyond that too. We can actually right click in here and notice if you wanted, you can hide those modules in there too. So maybe the camera calibration, you've got someone else using your computer and you don't want them screwing with that. You can do that. You can hide and show them right there. All right, tip number 5. We're working with video. In this case, I shot in D-Log, so there's not a lot of punch and contrast here, and I want to add it right here inside of Lightroom. So one of the things you'll find is if you click on the develop module, it's going to say videos not supported in develop, so you can't edit your videos. Or can you? Let's go back to our library here. We're going to twirl this open so we see all our details. And I'm just going to go somewhere in here, like maybe we're going to set this frame here. That looks beautiful. Click on the little box, capture frame. Now it creates a photograph. So I'm going to click on that photograph, go to the develop module, and now I can punch up my contrast, you know, recover my highlights, open shadows, blah, blah, blah. Let's just do this really quickly, add some punch to this, and say this is the setting we wanted. We could simply select the two now, and then just click on sync, and we synchronize it. And we go into the video now and go back to the library. And now look at that. We've now synchronized those settings from that photo to the video. And now look at that. We've got that beautiful tonality right there in the video. The other thing you could have done too is you could have just saved it as a preset if you want to reuse it. But if you don't want to clutter it up with a bunch of presets, just do the syncing like I did there. All right, tip number 6. You guys are probably aware of quick collections, right? You know, a quick collection, when you click on the little dot there, and then when you do that, it adds it into the quick collection right there. See that? And we can click in there, and we can see those images. All right, but what if we want to add them, you know, to a collection or something? We're going to go down here into the model collection. We're going to scroll down, and we're going to try and organize that. Well, here's a tip for you. If you want to be able to put them directly into one of these collections, like maybe I'll just create one right now, and I'm just going to call it Stuff. And, you know, it could be whatever you wanted. Here's the tip. You want to set this as a target collection. Now, if I click Create, now what we can do when we go into all of our photographs, let's just go back to our photos everywhere. When I click here now and I tap there, instead of those going into the quick collection, what they are now gonna do is go into the collection we just created. There's all our photos we added in the stuff. So if you move in there, you see the little plus. That's now set as a target collection, which now works like the quick collection. If you right click, you can turn that right off. And if you want, you can go anywhere and you can set that as a target collection just with that little plus. If I turn it off, by default, it's just gonna go back right now to the quick collection and notice the little plus sign is there. Okay, tip number 7, you've got multiple photos selected here and you wanna look at the metadata for each photo and you go down here, you can't because it shows mixed when you've got more than one photo. So what if we wanna actually see the metadata from each individual photo? Go up under metadata, show metadata for target photo only. Turn that on, now we see the metadata. As I click between these photos, we can now see the settings for each photo. So anyway, guys, that was 7 really quick tips inside of Adobe Lightroom. I hope you guys enjoyed it. So anyway, I've got lots of tips and tutorials I like to share. Make sure you hit that subscribe button right now, become part of the Cafe crew, and you'll get that every single week. Pound that like button into dust. Don't forget, add a comment, let's get a discussion going. And until next time, I'll see you at the Cafe.